to the Parliament protest because, to me, I was thinking I really wanted to do some music.
There's a lot of kind of unspent tension at the end of the day, and so it was Pepe's idea to sort of do this as a musical meditation, to just sort of like pre-bedtime, right before bedtime, and just to like even the energy out and settle everything down.
Instantly came to mind, especially this one piece, O Ignis Spiritus, which is the fire of the spirit, because it just talks about so many things to do with the spirit of the people and how it connect, how we connect to the nature and the land and the heavens and the rocks and the trees, and the universality and the ancient wisdom in her music.
Music has never been a source of pain for me throughout my whole life, but going into the end of last year, it seemed like it was a choice between practicing my art form or like maintaining my human rights to decide what happened to my body. So it was I didn't play for many months, and then the Parliament protest was like, okay, I'll get it out of the case again, and like, what can we contribute to that space?
Not so long ago, the word freedom was not considered a taboo word, and also bodily autonomy, bodily sovereignty, herbal medicine, acupuncture, all of those things were considered quite normal.
human beings have a need for a spiritual connection of some kind, right? And when the traditional institutions that provided society with spiritual guidance, and those aren't functioning in the same way, and then they don't have the same support. So the question is, where does that spiritual need go to, right? This sort of unquestioning trust in the scientific experts has taken on a sort of a zealotry, right? A sort of religious fever where it just cannot be questioned, right? And then to question becomes a sort of form of heresy.
This idea of being free doesn't mean being free to be a rebel. To me, it's being free to come home and be normal, be yourself, be your true self.